things of the day, friends. So here we are going to study the chapter number 7 of AC analysis of BJT and small signal amplifiers. So as we have studied up till the 5th chapter, there are different biasing methods there, over there. So from that methods, right now we are going to study the AC analysis of BJT. Is the chapter name suggest that AC analysis of BJT? So there will be obvious thing is that there will be two supplies, AC source as well as the DC source. So for the DC source and for the AC source, for the separation of the supply, what we need to do, that both the supplies need to be separated from each other by providing some kind of separation. So here name itself suggests that separation will be provided in terms of some capacitors, right? So what we need to do, that we need to amplify the AC signal. So for the AC signal, we need to allow the AC supply, and we need to also provide the biasing to the BJT. So for that purpose, there are two kind of capacitors are being used. One is for signal bypassing and second is for signal coupling. So here whatever the signals are there will be of AC, not DC. So for the AC signal bypassing, we need to use the capacitor, and for the coupling of the AC signal, we also need to use the capacitors. There are two kinds of capacitors there, namely they are coupling capacitor and bypass capacitors. So what is the difference between these two capacitors? Coupling capacitors are used generally for the coupling of the AC supply. You understand how it can be possible. See, as we know, XC, the reactance will be 1 divided by 2 pi FC. So here we know that DC supply has zero frequency, so it will not allow to pass the DC quantity. Or we can say in another language that DC supply is quite amplitude, direct amplitude compared to the AC. So as we know, the nature of the capacitor is like that it will oppose the instantaneous change, instantaneous current change. So that's why the capacitor will not allow the DC quantity, and hence your AC quantity will be passed through the capacitors. So in this way, the coupling capacitors are being used. Here you can see that if we put the frequency as zero, as we know that DC supply is zero frequency, so the term itself becomes infinite. 1 divided by 0 is an infinite term. So DC signals cannot pass through it. Right now we are understanding for the bypass capacitors, how it will bypass the AC supply. So for the bypassing of this AC supply, you know that AC supply has some frequency like 50 Hertz, 3 Hertz, 40 Hertz, 4 kilohertz, any of the quantity. So you will get a definite value, but it will be less. Why? Because the denominator term is very much less. As you know that a frequency, if we take the frequency as 50 Hertz, then reactance will be of very small amount. So XC can be taken as zero. So as AC signals can pass through it and bypasses the remaining circuit. See, these things are right now quite complicated, but as you know, as you study the basic circuits, as you have seen in some examples, that will be some capacitors are attached in the input as well as the output circuits as well as the emitter circuit. So these all are capacitors, are known as the coupling or the bypass capacitors, which are being used to couple the AC or bypass the AC. See, so right now we are going further for the next circuit, which you can get that clear idea of the coupling capacitors and bypass capacitors. So this is the basic circuit which I am showing you right now. There are three capacitors. First is over here, second is over here. These both the capacitors are known as the coupling capacitors, and this one, the third capacitor, is known as the bypass capacitors. So both the capacitors which are employed over here at the input circuit as well as at the output circuit are known as the coupling capacitors, and this capacitor which is being attached at the emitter circuit with the parallel of the emitter resistance is known as the bypass capacitor. As you know that it is bypassing the AC quantity through it. DC quantity need to pass through this path only from this path, no other ways. As you know that DC supply cannot pass through this circuit because you know that capacitor will oppose the rate of change of current, instantaneous rate of change of current, but it will allow the quantity which is gradually increasing, means slightly, slowly increasing with respect to the time. So this is the basic circuit of CE amplifier, which we can say that this is a voltage divider bias also, but it is used for the AC analysis. As we have seen there, there is a AC supply present over here, and as well as the DC supply is also there. So this kind of circuits need to be analyzed, and from this analysis we need some different types of parameters. These are some parameters. See, this is the input impedance, this is the output impedance. Impedance means what? That the resistance which is being offered by the particular circuit. So input impedance, output impedance, input current, output current, all these quantities are given in your book, and you need to study, or you need to read it from this from your textbook. So now we are going for the modeling. Now what do we exactly mean by the modeling? Modeling is a kind of analysis which we used to do from very long time. So in this kind of modeling, what we are doing, that we are simplifying the circuit in a very common electrical circuit, and after that we are trying to understand the particular behavior of that circuit. So we are taking this circuit only, this one, and we are analyzing that how can it will be simplified. So for the simplification of the particular transistor modeling, there are some rules which we also discussing today, and these rules are mostly for the AC equivalent circuits. See here, this is the circuit is called as the AC as well as the DC circuit. Both the common emitter circuit is there with both the supplies present over there, but we need to convert this circuit into a particular AC equivalent circuit. So as we convert this AC equivalent circuit, there are some rules that we need to remove the DC supply, and three of them are there. So that we are going to study, but first of all we need to know the modeling. What do we exactly mean by modeling? For modeling, we can say that if you are designing some circuit, or if you are designing some product, you need to analyze that product. You need to analyze that product. But how? So, for that, you need to particular see the each particle behavior in a different way or in a separate way. So, how that particle will work or how that part of that circuit will work in individual while whole circuit is going to be inputted or working. So in working condition, each and every part will be working independently, and what kind of behavior is there that we need to study in the modeling circuits. So the BJT transistor modeling which we are carrying out is particular need to do with the some shortening of the AC DC supplies, some shortening of this capacitors. So here we can see the conversion circuit is done. What I have done in this particular circuit, see, first rule is that if you need to model the transistor, then the DC supply need to be short circuited. This is the first basic rule. Second rule is the capacitors, means coupling capacitors as well as the bypass capacitors, all the capacitors need to be short circuited. And at the last, you need to design a circuit in a more simpler way, more logical way, so that you can apply basic rules of electrical, and you need to understand the particular behavior of that circuit analysis. So here I have converted the basic circuit. As you can see that I have done all that things which I have just spoken. So for the simpler of this, more simplification of this analysis, scientists have simplified this transistor also, that this transistor can be work as a two-pot network. Here is the two-pot network, and one network is shown is like this. That input resistance, then there will be some output resistance, input current, output current, and all the things, input output voltage, input voltage, and input current, output current. This all are the parameters which are being analyzed for the AC analysis. So this AC analysis is being carried out by us right now. And this analysis will be constructing of two models of transistors, which are T model and pi model. Pi model means what? That there will be a pi type of configuration and there will be a T type of configuration. In T type of configuration, what we are doing, that we are assuming that the transistor will be a part of a current source and of a resistor. Here you can see that this part is known as the internal resistance of a diode, which is being formed at the NPN transistor. So this is basically a forward resistance which will be negligible, but they are saying that this is the RE resistance which is over here, and the current source which is shown here is known as the beta IB. So this is the basic models. If you are not clearly can see these things, then it is already given in your book and you can study from there also. This is the T model basic, and one is the pi model in which is being shown over here. So in this thing also there will be a current source over here and there will be a resistance over here. So and we are taking the particular names of that circuits. Now when we are going into the AC analysis, so one thing you all need to remember is that the circuit symbols which we are using in the fifth chapter, they are RB means in capital forms, right? So now for the AC analysis we need to use the small letters of RB, RC, I internal resistance, RO output resistance, this all things, right? See, so we need to write in a small way, small letters, so it will represent that you are referring to the AC quantity. As you can see in your book, there will be some symbols which are in small captions. So small captions are used for the AC analysis. So this is the basic working of a CE amplifier, or we can say the conversion of a circuit. So conversion techniques is most probably, as we can see, that these are the basic rules. The first rule to model a transistor amplifier circuit is to convert it into an AC equivalent circuit, and for the conversion of that circuit you need to follow this three rules. That is, first is setting all the DC sources to zero and replacing by them by a short circuit. Second is replacing all capacitors by a short circuit equivalent. And third, redrawing the network in a more convenient and logical form by using T or pi model. Means you need to apply the T model or pi model, which is already given in the book, and that you have to remember it for the exam purpose. And you need to implement this T model or pi model instead of regular DC, regular transistor symbol, like this way. If you are using this kind of symbol for the drawing of the circuit, you need to replace it with T or pi model. So this is the basic learning of the seventh chapter of front two topics or three topics. This kind of questions may be asked in your exam, as they can ask you that convert the basic DC equivalent circuit into the AC equivalent circuit, or you can also be asked like that, convert the VDB amplifier, VDB CE amplifier into the AC equivalent circuit, or you can be asked that convert the CB amplifier fixed bias circuit into the AC equivalent circuit. They will not provide you the circuit, you need to remember at your own and convert that circuit into the AC equivalent circuit. If you go through these rules and try to practice these things to convert from your book, then definitely you will get some idea. If you are still not getting these things, you can ask me, as you all of you have my number. So these are the basic techniques. One point I need to discuss is that AC load line is there. AC load line that you need to study at your own. AC load line is nothing but it will completely dependent on the load resistance and the capacitive resistance, which is collector resistance. So we can say that AC load line can be decided by RC and RL. Both are in parallel condition. So whatever the equivalent resistance which they are offering, so that thing will decide your AC load line. So AC load line basic are that its slope is minus 1 divided by RC parallel to RL. Okay, so right now I'm ending my session over here, and if you are not getting much idea about this particular transistor circuits, then you can definitely ask me. As this video is formed for your betterment of your study, so kindly go through it, and if you are not getting anything, you can ask me. Thank you, and greetings of the day.